Neuropathy. Again, it's pretty hard to say. In the last few months, I've heard it a lot. Until last summer, I'd never heard of it before, and neither had my parents or the doctors at Texas Children's Hospital, one of the best in the world. My name is Justin, and I turned 13 in December. Last year, I had surgery in the spring that corrected my high arch on my right foot and helped me walk better. The doctors thought my deformed arch was due to a disease called Charcot-Marie tooth, CMT. But a few days before the surgery on my left foot, we got some bad news. We found out that I had GAN instead. When we thought I had CMT, it was bad enough. But I had accepted the possibility of ending up in a wheelchair. Now that we know I have GAN, my future is not so sure. Right after we got the diagnosis, my mom found Hannah's mom, Lori Sands, on the internet and called her. She seemed to know more about the disease than any of my doctors. My mom has talked or texted with her almost every week since then. She has been able to give us advice and support throughout the past year. She and the rest of the families with GAN have been there when we needed them. Our whole family is thankful to Ms. Lori and her family for everything they have done for us. Without them, we would have been lost. I'm sorry to say that a few months after my diagnosis, we found out that my 8-year-old sister, Lexi, also has GAN. While she has no visible signs of the disease yet, we both face the same fight. Lexi and I have the telltale curly hair that is common with kids with GAN. So while my parents held out hope that she didn't have GAN, tests proved otherwise. Even with all this, I still consider myself lucky. You see, it looks like I have a slower progressing form of this disease. Most children with GAN are in wheelchairs by my age. Next to my foot surgery, I can walk just fine for now. My twin brother Jared doesn't have the disease, but he is a carrier. We couldn't be more different. I have curly hair, he has straight. He likes to get up early, and I like to sleep late. He likes to exercise, I'd rather play video games. My parents say we fight each other just because we can. But this past fall, he did a half Ironman triathlon in my honor to help raise money. We asked people to pledge money for each of the 70.3 miles that Jared was racing for us. It took him 8 hours, 18 minutes, and 20 seconds. When he got close to the finish line, Lex and I joined him, and we all ran the last 50 yards across the finish line together. Last month, my parents asked our church to make a video of Lexi and me to help get the message of GAN out. They did a great job. It starts with clips of us, or the two of us, when we took our first steps. Most of the parents look forward to the day when their children take their first steps. Parents of kids with GAN wonder when we'll take our final steps. So far, our family, friends, and supporters have helped raise over $100,000 for Hannah's Help Fund. It's a great start, but we are still far from the finish line. With the promise of clinical trials in the distance, we seem close to a possible cure for all the kids with GAN. We just need to make it that last mile. Please help us. Hannah, my sister Lexi, and all of us around the world who are slowly dying a little every day from this horrible disease. I don't want to ever run another triathlon. I've done 3 and absolutely hated them. I just want a future for myself and for all the other kids with GAN. We don't live our lives in a wheelchair. We don't live our lives breathing with a respirator, but a future where we can walk and breathe on our own. We're all here tonight for one reason. That's to help find a cure for GAN. We need your help. Please help us cross the finish line together. Thank you.